I once again request the Chairman, sir, to formally welcome the Honorable Chief Guest with a bouquet of flowers. And to thereafter deliver the welcome address, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the proud privilege of having Sri Arun Jaitley, the Honorable Minister of Finance and Corporate Affairs, as our chief guest today. He is not an ordinary man. And when I say he is not an ordinary man, because he has extraordinary accomplishments to his name. I have always had immense faith in his capability, his competence as a leader, his integrity, his forthrightness. They have served me as a beacon light. And today, there cannot be a happier occasion than what it is now, because we kept on postponing our convocation in anticipation of his consent, which came after approximately a year. But I think to have a distinguished chief guest of the stature of Mr. Jaitley is something which will go in the annals of history of this institute. Honorable sir, it gives us immense pleasure to extend to you a very hearty welcome on behalf of the faculty members and on behalf of our students, the Director General and members of the Governing Council join me in welcoming you here. Give you an example of their entire political fail. All political maneuvering failed. They tried doing things, experimenting things. GST is one of those things where his policies prevail, his diplomacy prevail, his strategy prevail, and today GST is an example, living example of his financial management, how he is managing the affairs of the state. That goes hats off to him, because GST was almost a dream of every subsequent government. Government after government came, they talked of GST, but none of them had the competence and the articulation of what Mr. Arun Jaitley has accomplished. I'm so happy to see that people who were politically opposed to him had to agree to his logic. There is no other way to trigger growth in this country and to contribute to the national exchequer and to have a uniform tax all across the country. Sir, this credit goes to you that a state which is not ruled by our own party, that is Bihar, has also endorsed and passed a resolution in the assembly. What greater compliment can be there? That the bitter critics of our policies have endorsed Mr. Arun Jaitley's proposal, not only proposal, it came before the upper house, the lower house, and the house with the voice vote. They voted for your proposal of bringing GST. It's not a small accomplishment. Honorable Prime Minister has declared so many welfare schemes. And I'm glad to say that now around 250 million people in the country, across the length and breadth of this country, have an access to banking facilities. 250 million people have subscribed to Jan Dhan Yojana launched by the Prime Minister. Sir, it's supposed to be, that was your vision. 37,000 crores of revenue of the money has been brought to the government treasury. You have a futuristic vision. You are a visionary. You have shown the path that is not always the opposition, but it's the sense of reasoning that prevails ultimately. And the bitterness of the critics, they say, Mr. Chaitri, hats off to you. You have introduced GST, one of the economic reforms awaited for such a long time. Our GDP stands at 7.5, as against an approximation of 7.3, but in this quarter, from January to March, the GDP has grown 7.5. Prices of foodstuffs have started falling down. Pulses, which were skyrocketing, the prices have tumbled down. You have really been an asset to this nation. Your policies have really benefited the common man. A man living in rural areas can have access to insurance facilities by just subscribing to 330 rupees premium annually. And he's insured for 2 lakhs of rupees in case of any contingency, in case of any accident or anything happening. His entire future is secured. You are trying to reach out, you and your government has tried to reach out to the common minister of the common man, and that Bima Yojana has been introduced on the countryside and for the benefit of all those who have lost, who could not reach out to the banking facilities. Now each one of them have opened a bank account. There are many reforms for those EPL families living below poverty line, sir. LPG to all housewives. Big reforms have taken place under the stewardship of Shri Narendra Modi, and I must say that in the formulation of those government policies, you have immensely contributed. The way we see you as an ideal, as a role model, as somebody who was wanting for a long time this country, look forward to a man who didn't play politics, but had raised his stature to the level of a statesperson. Hats off to you as a statesperson, because you don't indulge in petty bickering or anything. No such bickering, nothing of the kind. The way he means everything seriously, and I've seen him researching on national and international issues, the way he deals with the tackle of those problems, his observation is very key. He observes everything. He observes every step. He observes every political development in the country. He's the finest analytic for a person who does such a critical analysis. He can predict what the poll results are going to be. He has the courage of a psychologist and a futuristic vision. He is blessed with a futuristic vision. So we are moved virtually by coming here. You have really blessed us on this auspicious day. I'll be doing injustice with my welcome address if I don't tell you that this particular 5 acres of land, it's because of his intervention. It is he who argued for 45 minutes, a senior advocate of the Supreme Court, comes and argues in the High Court, and the way and the manner in which you forward your arguments, each one of those arguments are so convincing that the judge was thoroughly convinced that this institution, which has been waiting for allotment of land for 10 years, need to be allotted 5 acres of land instantaneously. So it was 10 acres of land. But half of it was approved by 50 investors. So we have this land squarely, sir, because of the blessings, because in the manner that you have, I really have no words to say. And state a great deal of magnanimity. And the Supreme Court lawyer who is earning, and the way his bills are there, and let me sure share with you what moved me further. Please, Remember, faculty members, you need to sit down. Faculty members, you need to sit down there. The civility will stay for a little while more. But this will be gross injustice, miscarriage of justice, if I say. The Supreme Court has been coming down to the level of the High Court and arguing a case which was pending justice for a long time. We owe this 5 acres of land only squarely because of Mr. Arun Jaitley. Sir, we are beholden to you. Our hands are to you, sir. If you had not thought of this man in year 2007, perhaps you would not have been able to build this magnificent infrastructure. Sir, you express some anxiety with regard to the standard of education. Sir, Vivekananda Institute is the first preferred institute when it comes to preferring the law college. Or when it comes to preferring the School of Journalism and Mass Communication, Vivekananda School of Professional Studies is first to be preferred in the IB University. When the counseling takes place, they pick out press as the first choice. And we want to assure you, sir, we might incur losses. We might have to make sacrifices. But no sacrifice is greater than your vision of seeing that this makes a name and it stands out. None of the build schools, you know, 650 business schools are closing down when we decided to bring Professor Ayan Pandey from IIM Ahmedabad and to request him, you be our Director General and lead the management stream and lead the entire course of our this destiny, let it be in the same hands. We brought Professor J.L. Gupta, we brought Professor Kiran Tripathi, the brightest of the people, and we have in our political council most eminent educationists, journalists, chartered accountants, we have all those people who qualify to be on the governing council. So we are privileged to have you here, and we owe you a deep sense of gratitude. But we want to assure you, sir, we will keep your head high. You will never ever have to listen that any professor or lecturer or faculty is underpaid. They will be better paid than any university, central university or the state university. Thus, I want to give an undertaking. Because we want to take the standard of education higher. Higher than an average college. I've been chair of so many colleges, Keshav Mahavidyalaya, Shivaji College, and so on and so forth. I know the standard there also and my college also. We are going to set a benchmark soon. I will not take much of the time of the chief case because time is the first thing. He is wanted for bigger national issues. He has to address. I am a small stick in the wheel. But let me tell you, I respect him from the core of my heart. He is my ideal. He is my leader. He is my everything. He is a mentor. And I accepted him in toto. And when the two, you know, newly wedded couple comes, what the pledge is, I am waiting to you for eternity. So till eternity, we'll uphold you in high esteem, and this will bring a wonderful name, a good name to you. We will never embarrass you. We will rather give you moments of pride that this is one college which I gave them land and they have properly utilized it for a proper purpose. Thank you very much, sir. I'm honored.
Thank you so much, Chairman, sir.